and I'll get us back to a known state. Well, there we go. Now the next command that I want to show you is print object. And print object displays a description of an object that you specify. And the output that you'll get is similar to what would happen if you use the expression command and then use println like we just saw. Now the abbreviation for print object can all be done with PO. Instead of just like P space O, it's all PO. And we'll run this for the bugs array. And we can see that it is empty again. Now let's try running PO for self. And this time LLDB does its best to give us a description, just like we saw earlier when we were implementing printable and debug printable. But because those things are not implemented, this is the best it can do. So it gives us the type, breakpoint bug view controller, and the address. Now if we were to implement printable and debug printable like we saw earlier, then when we use the PO command, LLDB will choose the most specific protocol and show that description. So debug printable is considered more specific than printable. So if debug printable was implemented, it would show it. If printable is the only thing implemented, then PO would just display the printable description. So we'll show that as an example real quick. I'll stop and we'll go to the bottom of this file and let's implement these protocols in an extension. And now that we've implemented both the printable and debug printable protocols, let's try printing out self again. And we see that because debug description is the more specific, or debug printable is the more specific protocol, that's what's used. So hello from debug printable. And I'll stop and let's comment this out and only implement printable. Let's bring back up the same situation. Now if we PO self, we get hello from printable. So that was pretty cool, but now I really want to show off the flexibility of the command line interface. And this next example is going to be a little advanced. So don't worry if you don't follow everything the first time I show it to you. We're going to use it again in an example later in the lesson. So to start, what I've done is kind of set us up again. We're in the add bug to view, and we have a breakpoint set that we've reached, and I've already allowed it to run so that all these bugs were created. And then I've triggered it again by tapping when the breakpoint was active. And the reason I did that is because I wanted to be able to print out the bugs object. And you can see all of these image views here. And we're going to use one of these raw addresses. So I'm going to copy this for later use. And let's go ahead and clear this out. Make sure it's copied. Okay, there we go. So we're going to start with the expression command. But this time, we're going to use Swift's unsafe bitcast function. And the unsafe bitcast function, it's going to allow us to convert the raw address into an object that we can actually interact with. And this might be really useful in cases where you have the memory address for an object, but you're unable to access its properties and values. So let's see, can I actually look at bugs? There's one of them. And yeah, we can interact with some of it, but let's imagine that we couldn't. And there are cases where this will be handy. So here's how it can be used. The first argument is going to be our raw address, and this is the raw address that we saw earlier for one of our bugs in the bugs array. And we know that this address refers to a UI image view because that's what is contained in the bugs array. And so for the first argument we have the raw address, and then in the second argument we have the UI image view dot self, which is going to allow us to cast the address into a UI image view object. And we'll hit enter. So boom, there we go. LLDB has just converted our raw address into a UI image view object, and it's even stored it into a temporary variable called $R4. Now, if we wanted to instead use our own variable name instead of the $R4 or whatever it ends up assigning it, we can instead run the same expression and we'll use let $bug1. You need to use the $ that's special for the console and the debugger here. Enter. And now, if we run the expression println with our variable, there we go. So notice here the print output is the exact same output that we would get if we print out bugs. Where are we? Scroll up to the top. A lot of bugs here. Here we go. So for the first one, I think it stops right there. There's our first UI image view, and this matches exactly the UI image view here that's now contained in the variable bug1. And I can even change bug1's values. So we'll run another expression. So we'll say bug1.frame equals CG rect. And let's print this guy back out. And there we can see that the frame has now been updated to have X and Y of 0 and a width and height of 64. And because we know that bug 1 refers to the same thing as the first bug in the array, if we are to print out the bugs array, we should see the same thing. And there we go. So the frame for the first bug, 0, 0, 64, 64. Now, again, don't worry if this example is kind of hard to follow at first. We're going to demonstrate using this again later in the lesson.